Happy Wednesday, everyone. Welcome back to the workshop. Today we're going to be building up a kit sent over by modelroundup.com. They've got this in stock. It is by MiniArt. They produce a plethora of 1/35th scale military kits, 1/72nd scale kits. Those are the most popular military scale. Well, they are branching out into a larger scale. This is a 1/24th scale. So all of you that like to build the larger scale kits, the model cars in 1/24th, 1/25th, the trucks, now you've got a cool 1938 German agricultural tractor, or a Lanz Bulldog tractor, what they call it. This is kit number 24001, their first one. So this is going to be pretty cool to take a look at. MiniArt is well known, if you're not familiar with those military kits, as having some of the most accurate, most beautiful, most precisely molded styrene plastic kits in the world. So Model Roundup is going to be carrying their larger scale stuff, depending on how it sells, and they sent over this awesome little tractor to build up. You can see on the cover there, we've got a paint guide. Pretty much a paint guide. You can see the base colors, the way things should be shaded. So I'll be using this as we build it up and detail it. Let's start taking a look at all the parts that are in the box. We've got a double set of trees here for the wheels. You can see that those are gorgeous. Look at the molding detail on the little bolt heads and everything. Even getting super close, I don't think the camera can define that, but even little detents on the axles and stuff like that. Little locator marks. Look at all the little bolt heads around the outside. This thing has the steel wheels. Look at our tread bars, our spikes. These are meant to be driven in dirt. And on dirt roads, you will get two trees that are identical because obviously we have two rear wheels on this thing, two front wheels. We've got our chassis parts here. Look at how intricate that grid pattern is on the radiator. That's what I'm sure that is. But that, you know, it looks like it's brass, and they have that molded in that 1/24th scale. They're using all their skills from their smaller scale kits and really producing it. We've got our belt system here. Got our wheels. Look at the brake on that. That ultra cool. Super fine parts for gear shifts. Belt covers, chassis parts. I don't think there's much for engine in this because it's all hidden underneath the really thick body cladding. But you can see that fine, fine detail. I mean, look at that stuff. Little handles. So their 1/35th kits can be so, so precise. And I was afraid to build this thinking I'd open the box and find a bajillion tiny parts. But this doesn't look so bad. We've got the back of the cab. We've got our fenders here with our mounts. We've got our equipment mount off the back, molded open, as you would expect from MiniArt. You can see all the little bolt heads and all this stuff we get to weather and mess with. And here we've got our side cover, what you see right there. We've got our seat with all the holes molded open. You don't have to drill them out. You don't have to blackwash them. Got parts of our exhaust, our axle. Got a little spring there. Got our hood. Got our expanded metal. This is where your seat's going to go. Your foot pedals, your foot controls. Even got our linkage. Check that out. That is so cool on there. That's our one big tree there. That's it for the styrene parts. We've got a nice set of decals, which, because I'm going to be weathering mine, we'll want to put that stuff on right away after we get our paint coats on. We'll put that on so they have a chance to dry and we can weather over the top. Little manufacturer plates and instruction plates. Not much to do with this one. It's not like it has a dashboard or instrumentation. And then since we haven't done really a MiniArt on the channel before, we'll take a look at their instruction manual. Of course, it's in English. Couple mistakes on there. Decal sheet I included. So, but it is beautiful instruction manual, not a problem. Gives you your parts list, gives you an excellent color list. So take a look at that freeze frame it if you want to order your colors. Got all the major brand names. And then we've got our exploded views, which look very nice. Doesn't seem like there could be much confusion in those. They're pretty straightforward. Putting our hood on, you can see there's no real engine under there. It's just going to be our hood over the top. So roll through that, got that expanded metal that we showed. When we get to the back, we've got our full color decal and paint guide from multiple angles, and that's how the military modelers like it. So you can see you've got your options there. Then the instruction manual in certain areas will give you options as to how you want to do things on your model. So decide kind of, you know, the versions you want and get to building, which is what I'm going to do right now of the Lanz Bulldog. Thank you. we really had some time to get to know the kit. That build session was one of the longer ones, and you saw it all on film or digital video saving. So anyways, we've got the kit here sitting in front of us, and the reason I can build so much of this is because it's a farm tractor. So there will be some hand detailing, weathering going on, but mostly get the whole thing put together and work on it from there. And that's a personal preference. If you want to leave things off like the fenders and stuff like that, you go right ahead. The kit is able to do that. It has some good sized locating marks. We've got the drive wheels, we've got the steer wheels, we've got the belt and pulley and clutch system here. We can all paint up in one color. Then we've got our intake, our air cleaner, and our exhaust system on the table. We've got the main body of the tractor with that awesome seat and the steering. I did leave off the steering wheel. I will attach that at the very end just so I can get inside that cockpit driver's area and do some weathering and detailing. But the level of sophistication on these molds is really wonderful, down to bolt heads molded in. We've got all the spokes, the flat iron spokes across there. We've got our hubs built in. It really is a beautiful structure. So my guess is, and I'm not really sure, I didn't really look up anything, but since this is the outside of the drive system, I'm guessing the steel wheels are for road travel, crossing roads and stuff like that, even dirt roads and 38, there's a lot of those in Germany. But this will lift you up and kind of ride out on that. And then when you're in the field in the softer dirt, this thin metal wheel will sink in and allow the metal teeth to dig in without ruining everything when you cross it, when you cross your farm roads and stuff like that. The metal edges here, the bent metal, will not dig in and ruin everything. So it's a very nice design. Really cool looking with those spokes and a directional pattern on both sides of the wheels. Really digging that across there. I've never seen anything like that, even in the American stuff. And then we've got a slightly staggered, it looks like, appearance to those traction spokes. We got the other wheel built identical. We've got the front wheels, which are just a steel rib, and those wouldn't hurt anything. And then the steel rib would sink in a little bit across the road, but otherwise be fine. And then we've got that cross spoke technology, the outer hub, we got the cool little bolt holes and all that. So that stuff is really neat. I like how they designed that. Then our belt and pulley system, I'll paint this separately because a lot of these covers are removable. So we can display them open or unopen. So while we don't get a full engine under the hood to look at, we will have the major mechanics of the tractor to look at. So these will get painted the body color, and we'll accentuate those. These will get painted a metal body color, and then we can paint the belt. We can accentuate with some wear on there and some grease details. We've got the inner housing that will go on there, as we saw. That's why I kind of put it together in the video. It will key in and we can set it right there. Once it's painted, we'll glue that in place, and then we'll be able to put the belt and pulley system over it and glue that in place, and then we'll have a removable cover that can come on and off. We've got our intake, which once detailed will just bolt on right here to the little square that will hold in place. We can glue that in. And same with our exhaust. Got the oval attachment. That's why you saw me lining things up a couple times. And the brackets for the exhaust, which will line up to two little indents on the hood. So we can paint our exhaust, get it rusted up. The chassis itself is very, very detailed. I mean, down to like little chassis springs for returning clutch mechanisms and all that stuff. Looks really cool. Got our housing, and see how strong that is. For a while there, MiniArt had a lot of delicate plastic, and they've really improved the quality of it so it's not so brittle. But watch these linkages and all that. You could always paint those, put them on later. But I love that we're going to be able to put a cover on that, but then for pictures, expose that clutch mechanism with the clutch shoes and everything inside there. Very, very detailed. All of our support brackets and vents for the engine and our radiators. I'm pretty sure those are radiators since they're look like brass and they're all finned. And then we've got all of our caps for water, fuel. Got our seat in there with its molded open structure. Got our pedals, got our grips, got our clutches, got our shift levers, got our engagement levers for the axle, got our steering box there. All that expanded metal. Got our little toolbox hanging off the back bottom. Got our hitch. Got our attachment point here for all of our tools. Really extensive, and then got the beautiful Lanz Bulldog. I'll have to get in there with a very thin gold marker or a pen. Got all these different appointments with our little valve adjustments and all that. Got our front attachment, got our front axle. You could have steerable wheels. I glued them tight, but you could have these steer, just as you could also have the front axle articulate over structure like it would on the real tractor, so it would go up and down and sway back and forth. That's why it's only got that one bolt in the center. So that is really cool. We're going to be able to accentuate a lot of detail. So all I need to do in this one is get, like, there's three main colors. I'm going to do the covers in a reddish, which is an option I've seen online. I'll do the wheels in the same red, and then we will do the exhaust. We'll get the exhaust, but then the intake and the main body will be done up in the main body color. So I'm going to get over in the paint booth, and I will see you folks there.
Thank you.
Like I always say, never be intimidated by a kit. At least give it a shot to see what happens. And I decided to give this MiniArt kit a shot. I thought, well, I was kind of nervous because a lot of MiniArt kits have an absolute massive amount of parts in them. And they're super, super tiny. But my only experience with MiniArt kits is in 1/35th scale. They have beautifully translated their extreme skill in making models to 1/24th scale, giving us a nice large size Lanz Bulldog tractor. And this was a very easy build. The building session itself took quite a while to put it together, but there was nothing that was too tiny or too complex and stuff like that to work on. Now, there are things on this kit that you're not going to see on most model cars. Things like bolt heads. A lot of the bolt heads, even though the ones that are hardly seen, are actually molded onto the sprue, and you have to gently cut those bolt heads off and place them on the vehicle in the correct area. You'll get some much smaller pieces. You know, you can demonstrate that, like with the valve in the front. On most car models, the valve would be one large piece. Here, they did a small piece that sticks into the equipment, and then the valve actual handle, the knob, is a separate piece on its own. So you'll get stuff like that with MiniArt kits and these more refined kits, the more modern kits. But it builds up beautifully. Doesn't even need to have an engine to see. I'm sure a lot of you would like that, but it doesn't have one. But we do get the mechanics inside. We can remove the cover, the clutch cover on the side. We can take a look at all that stuff. I don't think right now there's any tools to hook onto the back, but you, of course, could always find something in 1/24th scale. They're probably out there somewhere. But this is a really cool looking tractor, and it didn't take a massive amount of work. You saw how I painted things, how I started to fade them with just spray paints. Then you saw me go in and start to do some bare metal work. I didn't want to do a lot of rust. I just wanted to do dirt. I love the box art where it's just some streaky dirt and stuff and some grease. I didn't want to crust and rust and rot it up. I angled the front tires just a little bit to give it a little bit of action on it. And I left those side covers loose so that I can take those off for photographs and we can see inside that. That clutch housing is really cool with the shoes and the springs and everything in there. Then you saw me use a very old model railroading fading technique to get a oxidized look. You see all that nice oxidation on like the pulley cover as it goes around. What I did when you saw there was I sprayed it with dull coat. I'm not sure how many other flat coats it works with, but I know the old timers always said use dull coat. So that's what I use since I have a very small amount of that. And then spritz it with alcohol. As long as it's 50% alcohol, you'll be fine. Doesn't matter what brand. Doesn't have to be MIG ammo alcohol. It can just be alcohol. Spritz it on there and you'll get these faded areas. You'll get spots on there. Regulate your mist, regulate your stream. And if it's too much, you can always puff a little bit of dull coat back on it. It will tone down that fading right away. And that's what I did. Then we got some dust effects. You saw me use my oil brushers. I don't use those a lot, but this is the perfect area for those oil brusher techniques and some makeup brushes to just scrape the oil brush down, rusted out our exhaust more than they did on the box art. I did mine just a hair more crusty and then gave the steel wheels a little more wear, knowing that almost all of the paint would be worn off. The front steer wheels, definitely in the center rib and on the side. And on those rear wheels, they've got the rear wheels completely bare steel. They've got a little more paint on the spikes than I do. And they've got a lot of paint on the front wheel. And that's what I wore down a lot more, knowing that as those turn and get shoved sideways into the dirt, they're really going to get sanded clean. Love this kit. They make a solid rubber tire version that's going to be coming out. So you can check that out. I will link in the description where Model Roundup has this in stock right now. And once again, I want to thank them for providing the kit for the review. And I want to thank all of you for coming along for the fun. Those of you who are asking if I still do weathered model kits, I knew I had this one in the pipeline. So I said, sure, come along. You're going to see something cool pretty soon. And it is. It's a really awesome model. And in 1/24th scale, will blend into any shelf with your cars and trucks and other models. Thanks for watching the workshop. I'll see all of you at the next review.
Thank you.